Welcome back. You're watching The Pulse. We're live from Bloomberg's London headquarters. I'm Guy Johnson.
And I'm Francine Lacqua. Now, the UK has managed to avoid a triple dip recession, but the economy is still ailing. Hoping to give it a boost, George Osborne is headed to London's tech city today.
The difficulty, though, is convincing investors to invest in startups at all here in Britain. Our next guest says he has the solution. John Medved is the founder and co-owner, CEO of Ourcrowd, a crowdfunding site that connects investors with startups based in Israel. He joins us now on set. I want to come to your business in just a minute, but we're in an economic slump here in the UK. Technology, tech city, startups are seen as one way by the British government of trying to get us out of that, replacing finance. But funding is a problem. Tell me how I fix it.
Well, first of all, there's no doubt that innovation is going to be up and to the right. It's a huge way to get out of the doldrums, and it's become a huge driver in Israel. Our economy has been growing at twice the rate of the OECD. There are 600 startups in Israel that are getting funding each and every year. There are 50 companies being acquired by multinationals, now 300 multinational R&D centers, and it's become the real beating heart of the Israeli economy. There's no doubt in my mind the same phenomenon can't happen here in England. The big issue is, how do you unlock the power of a crowd or of the masses to invest in these new startups? Because people would like to take a part in this great tech story, but until now, it's been basically a very closed game. A couple guys around a table, venture capital fund. If you're not hooked up, if you're not part of that insider group, then you're outside. So we've built a business called Ourcrowd, which basically unlocks that power over the internet. It invites accredited investors to come and to choose the companies they would like to invest in. Now, these companies have been pre-selected and vetted by a team of professionals. We put them together with this vetted group of investors and let the internet do its magic.
John, can you replicate this business model here in the UK?
Absolutely. In fact, we've just crossed the $10 million mark in a little over 5 months in terms of money that's been raised for 17 different startups. So we're actually putting up a deal every week. And this is massively scalable. And there's no reason why it only happens in Israel. In fact, of the 17 deals, we've already done three around the world, two in the US, one in Australia. And I'm here in London today, not only meeting with investors, because we hook up investors from around the world over the internet. One of the wonderful things about the internet is, instead of having a localized sort of funding group, you now have the ability for funders from Mumbai and from Shanghai and from New York and Silicon Valley to all actually provide that critical capital needed in Tech City.
One of the reasons why a lot of companies go with angel investors, with VCs, is that those VCs and angel investors provide them with a skill set that they don't have. I didn't get that with your model.
Oh, so our model actually is added value on steroids. And the answer is, when you get an angel, you get his Rolodex. Yep. When you get a VC fund, you get the three or four partners' Rolodex. When you get Ourcrowd, you get thousands of people's Rolodex. Yep. We're not just about crowdfunding, we're about crowd building. We have a little company in our portfolio called Lucid Energy, who basically unlock hydroelectric power from city water mains, would you believe, where there's water pressure going in. As soon as they came to Ourcrowd and got funding, and by the way, the company's from Portland, Oregon, of all places. We hooked them up with Israel. We have a great water cluster there. But more importantly, the people in Ourcrowd have provided introductions for this company in China, South Africa, Switzerland, Italy. All over the world now, deals are happening for this company because it's no longer about three or four people's Rolodex. It's about thousands of people's Rolodex. So the idea of crowdsourcing the building of companies to provide introductions to distributors, to resellers, to key hires, to press contacts. Just imagine what you can do when you figure out a way to unlock the power of the crowd. And this is really, I think, the next way. It's very disruptive in terms of the way that startups have been funded and built, and we're intending to make it happen.
John, what's the hot new thing at the moment? Is there a particular type of company or a service that they offer or that they manufacture that is attracting more investment than others?
Well, right now in Israel, we have about four main sectors. It's medtech, it's software, it's communications and the internet. Semiconductors, clean tech, we're doing it all. But we have companies ranging from a company called Surgical Theater, who figured out a way for a brain surgeon to essentially simulate his brain surgery before he opens you up. We have a company called NextPeer, which is doing synchronous, real-time, multiplayer gaming on your cell phone the way you would do it on Xbox. We have a company called Abe's Market, which is doing e-commerce for organic products, so it's sort of like Whole Foods meets Amazon. We have a whole series of companies. Literally, we saw last week 50 new deals. We had 50 submissions into our platform. We invite submissions from the UK. We invite submissions from all over the world. And we hope to, at some point, provide a solution for not just providing funding for Israeli companies and providing a way for investors to hook up to the Israeli startup scene, but to provide funding in a massive way around the globe.
John, thank you so much for that. Jonathan Medved there, Chief Executive Officer of Ourcrowd.